Hello and welcome back to SurelecTV. Hope you all had a really good Easter. Lots of chocolate was eaten. This episode is a fairly simple one really. Basically all I'm going to do is do a quick tool bag review slash electrician's tools, what I've got, what I haven't got. I've had quite a busy week, so I haven't actually had a chance to film any other content anywhere else, so hopefully this will be good enough for you. So yeah, as you can probably see in the background, I have just bought a new tool bag, as I was well overdue one. What I've bought is a Stanley FatMax tool backpack. I don't like massive tool bags, as you can see before. I just had a little kind of Stanley little tote. I've had that for about 4 years. I've started to cram stuff in and it's just splitting and it's been a bit awkward now. So yeah, I used a small tool bag just for a kind of ease just to carry about. It's quite small, nimble, but obviously you can't put a lot in it, to be honest. I also keep in the van this big plastic toolbox, which I keep my hammer, bolsters, that doesn't sound good, files, what else have we got in here, chisels, big set of crimps, up to 25mm, copper crimps, an old pad saw, some mole grips, yeah, just the big heavy stuff I keep in there really. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this tool bag apart, load this new one up, show you what I'm putting in there as I go. And yeah, basically you'll hopefully get a good idea of what an electrician has in his tool bag. Alright, what I'll start off by doing is showing you this new tool bag what I've got. As I mentioned, it's a Stanley FatMax. It's a backpack, so you've got nice padded shoulder bits there. It's all padded on the back, nice and soft. So hopefully if you're lugging it around for quite a bit, it's not going to cause you too much of a problem. Inside you kind of have this pull out kind of tote, and that folds out. You've got bits either side, you've got plenty of little slots there for screwdrivers, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so you've got like 20 odd gaps for single screwdrivers. You could obviously put more in there. Same again that side, like I said, that opens right out, so you've got more screwdriver bits there. These are a bit bigger pockets, so maybe your cutters, side cutters, Stanley knife, bits like that. And then the other side is even bigger gaps. So again, side cutters, grips, pipe grips, anything like that. I will show you what I put in mine. As you can see on that photo, they give you a quick idea where bits go. I suppose it's up to you where you put it. Inside you get this nice big kind of solid plastic bit at the bottom, just to stop any I assume just to hold the so inside the bag you get this rock solid bit at the bottom, just to keep the sturdiness of the bag. I assume that's kind of crack proof as well. A couple of big pockets, this one here I'll probably put my little multimeter in. Another little pocket up there. I think they're actually meant for a laptop or something, because this is a technician's tool bag, I believe. On the side, I'll probably put a hammer. Nice little bits here just to keep that in place. Could probably put all my insulation tapes through there. That's about it really with the new one. So I'll start loading it up with my tools and explain a few tools along the way.
Yeah.
feeling, yeah. Just take time and step. So we've just finished putting everything out of this old tool bag into this new one. So all we've got left in this old tool bag now is literally loads of junk, which I'm just gonna chuck straight in the bin because there's no point going through it all. So yeah, I'll go through the new tool bag setup. Like I said, I've got the tapes on the side, or the big reels of tape, and then I've got a few little ones in the front. A bit of self-amalg always comes in handy. And then the good thing with this tool bag is you get this little tote bit inside, which pulls straight out. So this side I've got my screwdrivers. That's a big kind of MCB screwdriver, Posi 3. I've got Posi 2, Phillips, big flatheads, the usual in there really. And then if we open it up, on this side we've got a pair of normal pliers, a pair of my CK side cutters. These are actually quite good, they're meant to be quite ergonomic, I think the word is. So you've got a 1525 stripper there, you've got a little, it's meant to be for cutting cable ties at the top, a little snip, your main snip in the middle, and then you've got holes here for 3.5mm and 4mm screws, if you should ever need to trim them, which is quite handy. They're actually quite a good side cutter really, I've been quite impressed with them. I've had them about three, four years now, and they're still pretty sharp. Obviously stay away from steel and things like that. So here's my normal pair of ratchet crimpers, so they do red, blue and yellow. They're pretty standard really, nothing special. Pair of pipe grips or normal grips, pair of shears for slightly bigger cables, adjustable spanner, little punch, always comes in handy when you're drilling into metallic stuff. Right, if we turn this round, it's a bit hard with one hand. So this side we've got a couple more pairs of pliers, these are just a couple of pairs of pin nose. We've got a 3.5mm tap, stubby screwdriver. Everyone's got a hitting screwdriver. This one's definitely seen better days, but that is literally just for hitting with a hammer. Quite good for doing up lock nuts sometimes if you can't get adjustables or pliers on there. Got my junior hacksaw in the back there. Don't think there's anything else in there. No. Right, we open this up again. So on the other side, let's get this back in here. Got my Stanley blade, got my Cat 5 punch, got my round file. I was looking for my half file but I can't seem to find that, so that must be in the van somewhere. I've got my pad saw, which is, I don't know if I can do this with one hand. It's actually a folder one, so this kind of, there you go, that folds out at different angles and that'll save your tool bag getting messed up, but that's a lot better than having the open one. We've got a little spirit level, and then we've got a little, I'll say little, it's quite big, ratchet screwdriver, comes quite in handy. And that is it for inside the tote. I'll pop that down here for now. In the bottom here, like I said earlier, you've got a big gap at the bottom. I've just put some spare hacksaw blades in. In this pouch here I've got all my spanners, well not all of them, I've got the main sizes like 10, 8, 13, just for the normal kind of M6, M8 screws, and a couple of big ones in there for bigger. Put my Fluke multi-function test or multimeter up there, sorry. And then that's quite good that this little tote literally slides back in there, zip does up. Sorry, it's a low place, a bit hard with one hand. So that does back up like so. Got my set of JCB Allen keys there, quite a handy set, imperial and metric. We've got around the other side, we've got hammer skewered in there, Stanley big 8 meter tape measure. And that is basically it for the tool bag. I've tried to keep a lot of the heavy stuff out. It's not too bad actually on the back. It's quite comfortable, like I said, it's got quite a bit of padding on there. Well, you can see that. But it's fairly comfortable really, even just over one arm. So I've now got two hands free to carry anything else. So I have to park quite away from a job. Especially when you're working in the towns and commercial places, not all the time there's parking directly on site, so you have to make a little trek. So this will definitely come in handy. Obviously I can carry my multifunction tester in another hand, or steps, anything like that. Right, I'll show you what else we've got in the plastic tool bag now, the rest of the tools. So like I showed you earlier, this is the kind of the box I just keep in the van. This never comes out of the van really. I've got the rest of my spanners in here, a few ratchet spanners. These come in very good, will come in very good use. Big size of 17mm, 19mm for the big M12 nuts and bolts. Got an electrician's knife, which I've actually had since college and I don't think I've ever used. A few odd screws that have fallen out, some more Allen keys. This is kind of just where I chuck odds and sods really. On the top of here I've got all my fuses. What else have we got? A couple of Allen blades, battery, some Loctite, that's quite good. A few bit crimps. We open this up. So like I said earlier, I got the big ratchet crimps for the big copper crimps that go up to 25mm. We've got our big Stilson's here, good for doing up big SWA glands on the bigger cables. Got another set of ratchet crimps for 10 and 16mm crimps. Got my bolster, it's done quite well. Obviously this is all big stuff that I don't really want to put in the tool bag, my backpack, because it's just going to weigh me down and I'll end up falling over backwards. Got the Rothenberg pipe cutter. Don't really use that a great deal, so that's in the box. Oh dear, I reckon a joint. Pair of tin snips, quite handy for cutting ceiling grid and the likes of. Comb chisel, another pad saw, that's how they normally come. Obviously you don't really want to put that in your material tool bag because that'll just tear apart, and so I've got the little fold away one, which is quite good. Pair of mold grips, obviously you can adjust the tightness on them just at the bottom. Pair of old cutters which haven't been used in years, need a bit of WD on them. Got a few chisels, these come in good handy. Oh, I found my half file, it's missing the handle somewhere. Oh, there it is. There you go, so that can go in my tool bag now. So yeah, the chisels, these do actually come in handy. Obviously I'm not a carpenter, but they are good. Set squares, very handy. One big one, one small one. And that's about it really. So there are a few of my tools, kind of the small stuff just to go in the tool bag. Obviously there's plenty more in the van. Maybe save that for another video. So yeah, overall first impressions of the tool bag itself are, it seems quite sturdy. I do like these bits at the front, so you could probably feed through whatever you want through there, clip-on keys. We've got another little pocket up here, I haven't decided what I'm going to put in there yet. Yeah, it does seem quite well. Like I say, I like the pattern on the back. Obviously we'll see how it serves the test of time really. Hopefully it doesn't fall apart. My other little bag done quite well, so I'll be happy if it does another 4 years. So yeah, as usual, hope you've enjoyed the video. Like I said, I do apologise, it's not the best content. I didn't have a lot of time during the week, so I couldn't record anything else. Yeah, the usual. Give us a like on Facebook. Subscribe to us on YouTube. Give us a like, comment, any questions, let us know. And we'll see you on the next video. Cheers, guys.